This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Herman Cain, born December 13, 1945, is an American author, business executive, radio host, syndicated columnist, and Tea Party activist from Georgia. He was a candidate for the 2012 U.S. Republican Party presidential nomination. Cain grew up in Georgia and graduated from Morehouse College in 1967 with a Bachelor of Science in Mathematics. Cain pursued graduate studies at Purdue University and graduated with a Master of Science in Computer Science in 1971, while also working full-time for the U.S. Department of the Navy in 1977, he joined Pillsbury Company in Minneapolis, where he later became vice president during the 1980s. His success as a business executive at Burger King prompted Pillsbury Company to appoint him as chairman and CEO of Godfather's Pizza, in which capacity he served from 1986 to 1996. Cain was chairman of the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City Omaha branch from 1989 to 1991. He was deputy chairman from 1992 to 1994, and chairman, from 1995 to 1996, of the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City in 1995. Cain was appointed by Newt Gingrich to the Kemp Commission, and was a senior economic advisor to the Bob Dole presidential campaign. Cain became the CEO of the National Restaurant Association, in which he served as president and CEO from 1996 to 1999 during the presidency of Bill Clinton. Cain publicly opposed the Clinton health care plan of 1993, about which he questioned the president at a town hall meeting. Cain has served as a member of the board of directors of several companies, including Aquila, Inc., Nabisco, Whirlpool, Reader's Digest, and AGCO. In May 2011, Cain announced his presidential candidacy by the fall. His proposed 999 tax plan and debating performances had made him the Republican front-runner, and he briefly led President Obama in the polls in November. However, his campaign struggled with allegations of sexual misconduct, all denied by Cain, and he announced its suspension on December 3 at the end of 2011. The Pew Research Center reported that, of the Republican candidates, Herman Cain was the most covered candidate during the year. On May 15, 2012, Cain endorsed Mitt Romney. Contents: 1. Family and personal life. 2. Education and career. 21. Burger King. 22. Godfather's Pizza. 23. Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City. 24. National Restaurant Association. 25. Media work. 26. Recognition. 3. Political activities. 31. Role in the defeat of 1993 Clinton health care plan. 32. Senior advisor to 1996 Dole campaign. 33. 2000 presidential campaign. 34. A Senate candidacy. 35. Americans for Prosperity and America's PAC. 36. 2012 presidential campaign. 361 straw poll victories. 362.9.9.9 plan. 363 campaign suspension. 37. Cain's solutions revolution. 38. State of the Union Response. 39. Call for a third party. 4. Bibliography. 5. See also. 6. References. 7. External links. Family and personal life. Herman Cain was born in Memphis, Tennessee, to Lenora Davis Cain, a cleaning woman and domestic worker, and Luther Cain Jr., who was raised on a farm and worked as a barber and janitor, as well as a chauffeur for the Coca-Cola Company. President Robert W. Woodruff Cain has said that as he was growing up, his family was poor but happy. Cain related that his mother taught him about her belief that success was not a function of what you start out with materially, but what you start out with spiritually. His father worked 3 jobs to own his own home, something he achieved during Cain's childhood, and to see his 2 sons graduate. Cain grew up on the west side of Atlanta, Georgia, attending school in the Rev. Cameron M. Alexander's Antioch Baptist Church North in the neighborhood now known as The Bluff. Eventually Cain's father saved enough money and the family moved to a modest brick home on Albert Street in the Collier Heights neighborhood. He attended Archer Public High School, graduating in 1963. Cain married Gloria Cain Nay Etchison, of Atlanta, soon after her graduation from Morris Brown College in 1968. Gloria Cain is a homemaker, with experience as a teacher and a librarian. The couple have 2 children and 3 grandchildren. In 2006, Cain was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer in his colon and metastasis to his liver and given a 30% chance of survival. Cain underwent surgery and chemotherapy following the diagnosis, and has since reported that he is in remission. Disclosures filed during his campaign in 2011 categorized Kane's wealth at that time as being between $29 and $66 million, with Kane's combined income for both 2010 and 2011 being between $11 and $21 million. Kane also serves as an associate minister at Antioch Baptist Church North in Atlanta, which he joined at the age of 10. The church is part of the National Baptist Convention and is politically liberal and theologically a conservative. The church's senior pastor, Rev. Cameron M. Alexander, does not share Kane's political philosophy. Education and career: accepted for graduate studies at Purdue University. Kane received a Master of Science in Computer Science there in 1971, while he also worked full-time as a ballistics analyst for the U.S. Department of the Navy as a civilian after completing his master's degree from Purdue. Kane left the Department of the Navy and began working for the Coca-Cola Company in Atlanta as a computer systems analyst in 1977, he moved to Minneapolis to join Pillsbury, soon becoming director of business analysis in its restaurant and foods group in 1978 Burger King at age 36. Kane was assigned in the 1980s to analyze and manage 400 Burger King stores in the Philadelphia area at the time. Burger King was a Pillsbury subsidiary under Kane. His region posted strong improvement in 3 years, according to a 1987 account in the Minneapolis Star Tribune. Pillsbury's then president Win Wallen said, "He was an excellent bet. Herman always seemed to have his act together at Burger King." Kane established the Beamer program, which taught our employees, mostly teenagers, how to make our patrons smile by smiling themselves. It was a success. Within 3 months of the program's initiation, the sales trend was moving steadily higher. Godfather's Pizza. Kane's success at Burger King prompted Pillsbury to appoint him president and CEO of another subsidiary, Godfather's Pizza. On his arrival on April 1, 1986, Kane told employees, "I'm Herman Kane and this ain't no April Fool's joke. We are not dead. Our objective is to prove to Pillsbury and everyone else that we will survive." Godfather's Pizza was performing poorly, having slipped in ranks of pizza chains from third in 1985 to fifth in 1988 under Kane's leadership. Godfather's closed approximately 200 restaurants and eliminated several thousand jobs, and by doing so returned to profitability in a leveraged buyout in 1988. Kane, Executive Vice President and COO Ronald B. Gartlin, and a group of investors bought Godfather's from Pillsbury Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City. Kane served as chairman of the board of the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City Omaha branch from January 1, 1989, to December 31, 1991. He became a member of the board of directors of the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City in 1992. He served as deputy chairman from January 1, 1992, to December 31, 1994, and then as its chairman until August 19, 1996, when he resigned to become active in national politics. National Restaurant Association. Kane left Godfather's Pizza in 1996 and moved to Washington, D.C. From 1996 to 1999, he served as CEO of the National Restaurant Association, a trade group and lobbying organization for the restaurant industry, on whose board of directors he had previously served. Kane's lobbying work for the association led to a number of connections to Republican lawmakers and politicians under Kane's leadership. The association lobbied against increases to the minimum wage, mandatory health care benefits, regulations against smoking, and lowering the blood alcohol limit that determines whether one is driving under the influence. Kane was on the board of directors of several companies, including Aquila, Inc., Nabisco, Whirlpool, Reader's Digest, and AGCO, Inc. After Kane's term with the restaurant advocacy group ended in 1999, he returned to Omaha for about a year, then moved to his hometown of Atlanta in 2000. Media work. Kane writes a syndicated op-ed column, which is distributed by the North Star Writers Group. Kane appeared in the 2009 documentary An Inconvenient Tax from 2008. Until February 2011, Kane hosted the Herman Kane Show on Atlanta talk radio station WSB on January 19, 2012. Kane began working for WSB again by providing daily commentaries, while occasionally filling in for Eric Erickson and Neil Bortz on October 1, 2012. Kane began writing weekly on online columns for the media organization Newsmax. In a series titled 999 to Save America, Kane took over Bortz's radio talk show on January 21, 2013. Upon Bortz's retirement, the program is heard weekdays on WSB from 9 a.m. to noon. It is also syndicated for airing on other radio stations across the nation on the Westwood One radio network on February 15, 2013. Fox News Channel announced Kane would join the network as a contributor recognition. Kane received the 1996 Horatio Alger Award and has received honorary degrees from Creighton University, Johnson. Political activities. Role in the defeat of 1993 Clinton health care plan. Kane publicly opposed the Clinton health care plan of 1993 as president-elect of the National Restaurant Association. He challenged Bill Clinton on the costs of the employer mandate contained within the bill and criticized its effect on small businesses. Bob Cohn of Newsweek described Kane as one of the primary opponents of the plan. The Clintons would later blame Harry and Louise, the fictional couple in the ads aired by the insurance industry, for undermining health reform, but the real saboteurs are named Herman and John. Herman Kane is the president of Godfather's Pizza and president-elect of the National Restaurant Association, an articulate entrepreneur. Kane transformed the debate when he challenged Clinton at a town meeting in Kansas City, Missouri. Kane asked the president what he was supposed to say to the workers he would have to lay off because of the cost of the employer mandate. Clinton responded that there would be plenty of subsidies for small businessmen, but Kane persisted, "Quite honestly, your calculation is inaccurate," he told the president. "In the competitive marketplace, it simply doesn't work that way." Joshua Green of The Atlantic has called Kane's exchange with Clinton his auspicious debut on the national political stage. Conservative politician and former Housing Secretary Jack Kemp was so impressed with Kane's performance that he chartered a plane to Nebraska to meet Kane after the debate. Kane credits Kemp with his becoming interested in politics. Senior advisor to 1996 Dole campaign. See also, United States presidential election, 1996. Kane was a senior economic advisor to the Bob Dole presidential campaign in 1996-2000 presidential campaign. Main article, Republican Party United States presidential primaries, 2000. Kane briefly ran for the Republican presidential nomination in 2000. He says it was more about making political statements than winning the nomination. George W. Bush was the chosen one. He had the campaign DNA that followers look for. However, Kane went on to state, "I believe that I had a better message and I believe that I was the better messenger." After ending his own campaign, however, he endorsed Steve Forbes' 2004 U.S. Senate candidacy. Main article, United States Senate election in Georgia, 2004. Indiana, 2004, Kane ran for the U.S. Senate in Georgia and did not win in the primaries. He was pursuing the seat that came open with the retirement of Democrat Zell Miller. Kane sought the Republican nomination, facing Congressman Johnny Isakson and Mac Collins in the primary. Collins tried to paint Kane as a moderate, citing Kane's support for affirmative action programs. While Kane argued that he was a conservative, noting that he opposed the legality of abortion except when the mother's life is threatened, Kane finished second in the primary with 262% of the vote, ahead of Collins, who won 206%, but because Isakson won 532% of the vote, Isakson was able to avoid a runoff. Americans for Prosperity and America's PAC. Starting in 2005, Kane worked for the political advocacy group Americans for Prosperity AFP alongside Mark Bloch. Bloch would later become campaign manager for Kane's 2012 presidential run and would be joined in Kane's campaign by several other AFP employees. Kane continued to receive honorariums for speaking at AFP events until he announced his campaign for the Republican nomination. Kane's senior economic advisor during his 2012 presidential campaign, Rich Lowry, who helped devise Kane's 999 tax plan, had served on the AFP board in 2006. Kane voiced several radio ads encouraging people of color to vote Republican. The ads were funded by a group called America's PAC and its founder J. Patrick Rooney. 2012 presidential campaign. Main article, Herman Kane presidential campaign, 2012. Kane speaking at the Ames Straw Poll in August 2011. In 2010, Kane addressed more than 40 Tea Party rallies, hit all the early presidential states, and became a YouTube sensation. On September 24, 2010, Kane announced that he was Considering a run for president in 2012 on the Republican Party ticket in December, Kane was the surprise choice for 2012 GOP nominee in a RedState.com reader poll. Kane announced the formation of a presidential exploratory committee on January 12, 2011, and officially announced his candidacy on May 21 in Atlanta straw poll victories. A popular speaker, Kane's addresses to conservative groups were well received, and in late September and early October 2011, Kane won the straw polls of the Florida Republican Party, TECN, and the National Federation of Republican Women's Convention. My focus groups have consistently picked Herman Kane as the most likable candidate in the debates, says GOP pollster Frank Luntz. Don't underestimate the power of likability. Even in a Republican primary, the more likable the candidate, the greater the electoral potential. 999 Plan main article. 999 Plan. In July 2011, an advisor suggested that his campaign's tax policy plan be called the Optimal Tax, but Kane rejected the name, saying, "We're just going to call it what it is, 999 Plan." The plan would replace the current tax code with a 9% business transactions tax, a 9% personal income tax, and a 9% federal sales tax. During a debate on October 12, Kane said his plan expands the base, arguing that when you expand the base, we can arrive at the lowest possible rate, which is 999. An analysis released to Bloomberg News by the campaign claimed that the rate for each of the three taxes could in fact be as low as 73%, but poverty grants. Two of the four women came forward publicly, Sharon Bialik and Karen Krauschar, on November 28, 2011. Kane asserted that a woman named Ginger White would be claiming to have had an affair with him, and that the allegation was not true. An interview with White was aired an hour later on Fox 5 in Atlanta. In the interview, White said the affair lasted 13 years and ended right before Kane announced his presidential campaign on November 30, 2011. Herman Kane denounced allegations of sexual harassment and adultery as character assassination. During an event in Dayton, Ohio on December 3, 2011, Kane announced he was suspending his campaign for the presidency following allegations of sexual harassment and adultery, which he denied, but were widely considered responsible for the sharp drop in his poll numbers. Kane's Solutions Revolution. On January 4, 2012, Kane announced the Kane Solutions Revolution. Kane's stated goal was to get commitments from members of Congress to support the 999 plan before the 2012 elections. Kane stated that he started a new movement because the biggest comment I got when I ended my candidacy was to keep 999 alive. That's what this is about, and I'm going to keep it alive with what I'm calling Kane Solutions Revolution. In order to promote this movement, Kane was using both a bus tour and a new website. New York Magazine stated, "It's Kane's earnest effort to keep 999 alive and focus on solutions." On January 20, 2012, Kane spoke at Stephen Colbert's Rock Me Like a Herman Kane, South Kane-Alena primary rally. The Huffington Post reported the crowd size was between 3,000 and 5,000 people. It had been called the largest campaign rally so far during this GOP presidential primary season, and the biggest political rally of the primary season. State of the Union response for President Obama's 2012 State of the Union address. The Tea Party Express chose Kane to give its second annual response after Indiana Governor Mitch Daniels gave the official GOP response. Kane delivered his speech at the National Press Club. The speech was streamed live on the Tea Party Express website. Kane referred to Obama's address as a hodgepodge of liberal ideas, adding that there were no big ideas that would impact job growth and no big ideas that would stimulate economic growth in this country. Call for a third party after Barack Obama's re-election in 2012. Herman Kane told Brian Fisher that the Republican Party no longer represented the interests of conservatives in the United States and that it didn't have the ability to rebrand itself, so a third party, not Ron Paul and the Ron Paulites, but a legitimate third party, would be needed to replace it. Bibliography: The Intangibles of Implementation, in the technical journal Interfaces, Volume 9, Number 5, 1979. pp. Carrot, Kane, Herman, Current Biography Yearbook 2011. Ipswich, M.A., H.W. Wilson 2011. pp. Carrot, ABCDEF. Henninger, Daniel. September 29, 2011. Taking Kane Seriously. The Wall Street Journal. Archived from the original on May 9, 2011. Retrieved May 28, 2011. 2012. Civil Liberties Views of Herman Kane. CivilLibertyAbout.com. Retrieved January 15, 2012. The Political Vine, July 17, 2004. Retrieved February 6, 2012. Carrot Costa, Robert. September 27, 2011. Herman Cain's Kemp Connection. National Review. Retrieved October 3, 2011. Carrot Pappas, Alex. September 24, 2010. Herman Cain, former Godfather's Pizza CEO, is contemplating 2012 run. The Daily Caller. Retrieved September 24, 2010. Carrot AB John D. McKinnon, Cain plans Reagan era roots. The Wall Street Journal. October 14, 2011. Carrot AB Stephen Sloan and Richard Rubin, Cain reveals 999 math with projection of no revenue loss. Bloomberg News. October 13, 2011. Carrot interview with Herman Cain. Aaron Burnett. Outfront. October 12, 2011. Carrot Paul Krugman, Cain unable. The New York Times blogs. October 15, 2011. Carrot Cain the tax code killer. National Review. October 14, 2011. Carrot Seth MacLachlan, Club for Growth defends Cain's 999 tax plan. Washington Times Inside Politics. October 14, 2011. Carrot John Rossomondo, Paul Ryan loves the idea of Herman Cain's tax plan. October 13, 2011. Carrot Kenrick Ward, Herman Cain's revised 909 tax plan raises new doubts. Sunshine State News. October 25, 2011. Carrot Abkarian, Robin. October 18, 2011. Vegas debate. GOP rivals jump on Herman Cain's 999 plan. Los Angeles Times. Retrieved November 10, 2011. Carrot Martin, Jonathan, Maggie Halberman, Anna Palmer, Kenneth Vogel. October 31, 2011. Herman Cain accused by two women of inappropriate behavior. Politico. Retrieved October 31, 2011. Carrot Summers, Juana. January 4, 2012. Herman Cain to launch 999 bus tour. Politico. Retrieved January 4, 2012. Herman Cain responds to State of the Union Talking Points memo. Retrieved January 25, 2012. Financial information at OpenSecretsOrg. Column archives at the North Star Writers Group. Watch Herman Cain battle Bill Clinton on health care. Joshua Green, The Atlantic, January 2011, with profile business positions preceded. Stephen C. Anderson government offices preceded. VP nominee Dick Cheney candidates Lamar Alexander Gary Bauer Pat Buchanan campaign Herman Cain Elizabeth Dole Jack Fellier Steve Forbes Orrin Hatch John Kasich campaign Alan Keyes Andy Martin John McCain campaign Dan Quayle Bob Smith Democratic Party convention primaries. Nominee Al Gore campaign VP nominee Joe Lieberman candidates Bill Bradley campaign Lyndon LaRouche Paul Wellstone Constitution Party convention nominee Howard Phillips VP nominee Curtis Frazier candidates Herb Titus Green Party convention nominee Ralph Nader campaign VP nominee Winona LaDuke candidates Jello Biafra Stephen Gaskin Joel Koval Libertarian Party convention nominee Harry Brown campaign VP nominee Art Olivier candidates Jacob Hornberger Barry Hess L. Neil Smith Reform Party primaries nominee Pat Buchanan campaign VP nominee Azola B. Foster candidates John Hagelin Donald Trump campaign Natural Law Party nominee John Hagelin VP nominee Nat Goldhaber Prohibition Party nominee Earl Dodge VP nominee W. Dean Watkins Socialist Party nominee David McReynolds VP nominee Mary Cal Hollis Socialist Workers Party nominee James Harris VP nominee Margaret Trow Workers World Party nominee Monica Moorhead VP nominee Gloria La Riva Independent Kathy Gordon Brown Charles E. Collins Isabel Masters Joe Schreiner Jeb Bush David Boies Theodore Olson James Baker Ron Klain Warren Christopher Michael Woolley Benjamin Ginsburg Bob Butterworth Joel Baugh Max Stepanovich Craig Waters Teresa Lepore Carol Roberts Election Day Florida Central Voter File Scrub List Volusia Error Chad Butterfly Ballot Aftermath and Legal Proceedings Florida Election Recount Brooks Brothers Riot Palm Beach County Canvassing Board v. Harris Harris I. Gore v. Harris Harris II Bush v. Palm Beach County Canvassing Board Bush v. Gore Films Recount 2008 Bush Family Fortunes 2004 Unprecedented, the 2000 Presidential Election 2002 Other 2000 Elections House Senate Gubernatorial v. E. 2008 Positions incumbent VP nominee, Joe Biden positions challengers, Bob Ely Keith Judd Warren Mosler Darcy Richardson Jim Rogers Vermin Supreme Randall Terry John Wolf Republican Party convention primaries debates statewide polls national polls straw polls Newspaper endorsements nominee, Mitt Romney campaign endorsements positions VP nominee, Paul Ryan positions candidates, Michelle Bachmann campaign Herman Cain campaign Jack Fellier Newt Gingrich campaign Stuart Greenleaf John Huntsman campaign Gary Johnson campaign Fred Karger Andy Martin Thaddeus McCotter campaign Jimmy McMillan